the primal dew, hash maize that grew to feed the few, that early ancient morn.
Sensitive morals might suffer a lapse, for sure they'll suffer a lapse.
Dow, 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 doo.
Yes, sir, Captain, my captain, let's grab the skiff and oars. See the cute little village between them tall trees and shore.
you have damned both yourselves and these niggers ashore.
Yada yada da da da.
Yes, sir, Captain, my God.
To my family and friends. show. It was a time before white men came. The skies were clearer back then, yet more will soon come again. And when they do, we must learn to live with them.
Thank you. Yes, those early years brought some joy to our young people as they were protected from the adult talk of conflict and politics and were allowed to grow up as normal adolescents. Massasoit and Sachem Corbettant of the Pocassets tribe who speak apart from their families whom they brought along for their meetings. Massasoit's teenage sons, Wamsuta and Metacom, who had received the English names of Alexander and Philip at the request of their parents, would walk from the wooded camp to the ocean shore. They were often joined by Corbinet's girls, Weetamoo and Wodonakanusk, delighting in a trip out of the dark woods into the brilliant sunshine of the beach. Years later, as Weetamoo grew, she became a beautiful woman. She was much sought after as a wife of other sachems, allied with the Pokanokets, and became betrothed to a sachem in Saugus. Alexander, her boyfriend's sweetheart, was devastated, but the girls of her tribe were excited at the thought of a wedding.
Thank you.
her husband died a year later. She returned to her father's tribe, soon becoming the sachem of the Pocassets, when her father, Pocanokets, passed away. Alexander's earlier devastation, after losing Weetamoo, was replaced with joy as his long-awaited marriage to her came to fruition. Weetamoo's sister, Rhododendronous, had married Alexander's brother, Philip, but this marital bliss for the two families was not destined to last. With the death of Massasoit, the fragile coexistence of our people with the English deteriorated. The earlier conflicts of the English trampling our crops without remorse, ruining our hunting areas, and breaking our treaties, plus their continued racism and disrespect toward us, all forced a meeting with now sachem Alexander and the Pilgrim representatives. Our robustly healthy Alexander died soon after this meeting, poisoned by the Pilgrims. Initially a peaceful and patient man, Alexander's younger brother Philip became enraged as he assumed the position of Grand Sachem of the Pokanokets. His charisma was on full display as he, now titled King Philip by the English and Weetamoo, aroused our people for war.
To lead our nation, for we know it is the right. Now's the time to
Our brave ancestors fought with great success at the beginning of the war. Weetamoo, like King Philip, was feared by the English for both her daring raids and for her successes in battle. They had many triumphs in many towns, as you will see. Many of our members had died. Many others were wounded, and those remaining were weakened by hunger. The combined army retreated to our hidden village in the swamp of our native land. They felt safe there, but they realized that their nation, that started with 8,000 people, had suffered greatly over the 76 years. From 1600, the start of my story, to 1676, the year they were together at the swamp with so few remaining. In the battle that ensued, he killed King Philip. The English cut off Philip's body and put his head on a pole at the entrance to Plymouth. For 25 years afterwards, hard as that is to believe, Weetamoo escaped the battle alive, but she drowned in a river as she was pursued by the English troops.
Oh.